So for the first one, they've given us four standard electric potentials. The first question they're asking me, well, they want me first of all to calculate the voltage, which is quite easy, and then to calculate what reaction will actually take place. So these are the two that they're interested in. Cl2 going to chloride and copper 2 plus going to copper. So first of all, what is the difference between 1.36 and 0.34 volts?
1.2.
It's going to be 1.02 volts. So that's the voltage that I would see. The next thing they want me to work out is what reaction will actually take place. The most positive will go from
left to right.
Left to right. That one, therefore, is reverse, but hang on. When I combine these, I've got to make sure that my electrons are the same. So this one has to be times by
2.
So that becomes Cl2 plus 2 electrons goes to 2 chloride ions. And then the reaction will take place will be Cl2 plus copper goes to 2 Cl minus plus copper 2 plus. So that will be the reaction that takes place. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, copper you kind of would expect to react with chlorine.
So you don't add on the electrons?
No, the electrons are cancelled out.
Yeah,
remember we did that last week. Those electrons cancel. So we make sure they're the same, which is why you must always reverse one. So one of these you always reverse, and the one you reverse is the more negative one.
I understand how you do that, but the question...
Let's do the second one then. So first of all, I've got Fe2 plus an iron and chromium 3 plus. What is the difference between minus 0.44 and minus 0.7?
0.3
volts. So if whatever the reaction is, it'll put it as that. Which is the most positive? This one is most positive,
yeah.
So that one's going to be reversed. But remember, my electrons must match. This one I'm going to times by
3.
So that becomes 6. That becomes 3. This one by 2. The reaction that will take place will be 3.
Is the arrow saying something
else? Fe2 plus, where are we? Plus 2 chromium goes to 3 Fe plus 2 chromium 3 plus.
No, you're
alright. Okay, Stephanie.
I was going to say, I can't remember what I said. What did I say?
Yeah.
Oh, I said, does the arrow show which one's reversed?
Yeah, that one's showing me that this one's reversed. Shall we do the last one?
I see.
So the first one is that, the last one is chromium 3 plus and chlorine reacting. Oh, chromium 3 plus and it's also the chlorine one. So.
Times
the
chromium
3? Let's have a look.
Yeah.
So if I go back, that one was 3, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That one's 2.
So
I need to do that one to 2.
No, the Cl was originally 1.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, that's fine. So I can just times that. That becomes 3. That becomes.
Because you didn't start with 1.
3.
Cl2 is
a half. Yeah, that becomes 1.5 Cl2s, doesn't it? That becomes 3. And that becomes.
3.
Yeah, that's okay. Okay, so first of all, let's do the easy thing. What is going to be the voltage between that one and that one? The difference between 1.36 and minus 0.74? 2.1 volts. Cool. What will be the reaction that will take place? Well, this one by far is the most positive. So this one will be 3.5. Cl2. One and a half. 3 over 2. Plus chromium,
balance the electrons.
Goes to chromium 3 plus, plus 3Cl minus. Yep, we're happy with that.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Okay, cool.
That's pretty much all there is to it, in terms of this.